How we doing, everybody? This is Rusty here at FCP Euro, and today we're going to show you how to install the transmission mount insert in our B9 Audi S5. The kit we have in front of me on the table here today includes all the hardware you'll need to install and replace the transmission mount insert, as well as the transmission mount. Aside from all the hardware in the kit, we will be installing the 034 motor mount insert. This is going to take up a little bit of the slack that the factory mount has, making sure that the transmission moves a lot less, giving you that crisper shifting feel. Aside from that, we'll be replacing the existing transmission mount with this stiffer rubber insert, so that will be taking care of a lot of the slop that you're feeling in this stock mount. This will make for a much crisper shifting feel and will definitely accompany the insert as well. Now that we know what we're working with, let's go over some of the tools that we'll need to get into the job. In doing today's trans mount insert, as well as the replacement of the trans mount, here's a couple of tools that we'll need to do the job. We may find it helpful to use a 3/8 impact as well as a 3/8 ratchet. A couple of triple squares we'll be using here today. We have a 12 millimeter triple square, as well as a 10 millimeter triple square, a 6 millimeter Allen for the replacement hardware, along with a 13 millimeter socket. And finishing up, we will need a 3/8 torque wrench to tighten some of our fasteners. That being said, let's go ahead and get the job started. So we're gonna start by removing these two exhaust hanger brackets and just swing them out of the way. We've already supported the backside of the transmission. You just wanna lift it slightly off of the transmission mount so that when you unbolt everything, it doesn't jump down at you. It doesn't need to go very high. We just wanna support that just enough to take the pressure off that mount when removing the hardware. So there's a couple 10 millimeter triple squares in the exhaust hangers. We're just gonna zip these out real quick and flip those hangers around. Once you have the exhaust hangers loosened up, we're gonna go ahead and start removing the 13 millimeter bolts on the bottom of the bracket. As I loosened that last bolt, this became somewhat loose. Now we have the ability to push the transmission up just a hair. Try to pry these exhaust hangers off. Get these out of our way. All right, so as you can see, we've got the bracket loose. However, we're noticing that we're unable to drop it without releasing the clamps in the back. We do have a resonator delete kit in this car, which not everyone's gonna have. So we do have the ability to release the clamps here, but just to show you guys at home who may actually have resonators in the car, we're gonna loosen up the clamps back here and see if that allows us to spread these exhaust hangers a little bit further towards the outside of the car. So with a 13 millimeter, loosen up your exhaust clamps and slide them back. Looks like that's gonna give us plenty of room that we need. So I'm just gonna gently lower these down, trying not to hurt the flex pipes. All right, it's definitely not easy. Definitely wanna be careful. There's not much room to support the transmission in the back. You may have seen me manipulating this pole jack a little bit. You really want to ensure that this carries the weight of the transmission the whole time, because there's nothing else supporting the transmission. It will be hanging by the engine and the engine mounts. So make sure that when you're moving this bracket around, you don't manipulate that support too much, and you want to make sure that you have plenty of clearance. We were definitely running into some issues with the way we had this supported. So once we have the bracket released, we do want to remove this additional bracket that goes into the transmission. The transmission mount itself, you can see, is inserted above the lower bracket here. The insert's gonna go in here, then that's gonna fill this void here, as well as replacement of that. So let's go ahead and take the 12 millimeter triple squares down. Now, once we have this out of the way, we're able to get to that one 13 millimeter nut on the top, which will allow us to separate this and install our new heavier durometer mount. So it's just a 13 millimeter on the outside here. We're gonna use an impact gun to pop that loose. And then we're just gonna separate that. We've already released the fastener from the bottom when we released all the other fasteners holding the bracket on. We should be able to pry this out. All right, so we've taken out our main transmission mount. And if you noticed in the video, we kind of were surprised that the mount had basically fallen apart in our hands. The place where the insert's gonna go is where I'm forcing the center section of this out. So if you're in the same situation as us, we found it necessary to replace this mount at the same time. So although the insert is gonna take up the slack on a good mount, it will not really do much for you if the mount is completely disconnected. So we've already separated the existing transmission mount before realizing that the insert was falling apart. So now that we have the new unit, we'll have to do the same thing by just hammering the stud through to get that out, so we can install our 034 transmission mount. So it's not forced in there very much, but you will have to give it a couple of good taps. We have our new mount bracket. We have our 034 street density transmission mount. And then we have the factory mount that bolts up to the transmission. Before we start reassembly, we do want to take note that the longer side is the side that's going to be going into the sub mount. The shorter side is the side that's going to be going up into the bracket. If you were to install the long one, that would more than likely hit the transmission before bottoming out these bolts. So you want to pay very close attention that the short threads are going up towards the transmission upon installation. Snug that down. And then we're going to torque that to 20 Newton meters. All right, now that that's fastened, make sure that the mount isn't twisted in any way, and then we'll go ahead and install this up onto the transmission. Fit your mount to the transmission, make sure all your bolt holes align, and then with new hardware, we're going to be installing these 12 millimeter triple squares into the transmission on all four corners here. I'm just going to snug these up with the gun and then torque them to 40 Newton meters. I'm just going to do it in a diagonal pattern. Just because that's what I prefer, that's what I'm used to. There is no wrong way to tighten these up. All right, now we've got all that secured, we've got the mount secured. It's time to go reinstall our bracket. In order to install our support here, we will rehang our new mount. You may have your existing one. We do have our fresh new mount here because ours fell apart in our hands. Making sure the angled portion of this is towards the back of the car, and I guess you could call this the U shape, is going towards the front. All right, now that we've made clearance past our pole jack, we can successfully line all these up. There we go. So we did have this bracket loose because we don't want to tighten these in a fashion that's going to prematurely wear that bushing. So we do want to make sure everything's kind of in a relaxed state when we tighten it all up. Now there should be some witness marks from where your old hardware was. There is a little bit of ability to move this bracket side to side, so you do want to try to get that back into the same place that it was. It may be helpful to make some marks around the bolts before removal. If yours wasn't as dirty and had some oil underneath, then we were lucky to have as a witness mark. That being said, we're going to go get our new hardware and start to assemble the outside of the mount to the body before finishing off with the actual mount itself. All right, again, make sure that you have the transmission mount loose, and we're going to tighten all these mount bolts out, lowering the trans down before fitting everything else. And we're going to be torquing these 12 millimeter triple squares that go into the body to 55 Newton meters. All right, with our transmission mount secured, again, our mount is still fairly loose. We just want to kind of find a relaxed home for this so that it doesn't get torqued down in a fashion that would hyperextend the mount or anything like that. So we're going to lower the transmission down, letting it rest in that mount bracket, and it is no longer loose in there. And then we just have a series of 13 millimeter nuts on the bottom here. Before we tighten any of these up, we do want to just double check and make sure that the subframe mount insert, the threads for the bolts that are going to go through there, are lined up with the holes here. If they're offset at all, you may cross thread the hardware and going into that bracket. So let's just double check with a flashlight real quick. I'd say they're pretty lined up. So for the 034 insert, it is just going to go in like that. We are going to grease these tabs a little bit just to make our lives a little easier with insertion. And then once that's in, we have two new bolts to go in there with Loctite, and we'll torque everything down together. All right, so with a little bit of the PowerFlex polyurethane bushing grease, which is waterproof, any waterproof grease essentially will work. This is what we've chosen for the application here today. Once you've greased the surrounding area that is going to be installed into the mount, or able to push that in, it will go either way. So simply like that, go ahead and install that. So in the kit from 034, we do have a dash of blue Loctite to ensure that these new fasteners do not come out. I'm just going to put a little bit on the threads. You don't have to go crazy. It's just to help keep it in place. We're going to go ahead and install these into our new insert. And you're definitely going to want to run these in by hand, making sure that they catch the threads before starting to snug them both up. And once you're sure that they are going in correctly, we can start running those home, and you're going to be torquing these 6 millimeter Allens with the blue Loctite to 30 Newton meters. It doesn't really matter which orientation you torque these down in. We're going to do these two bolts here to 30 Newton meters, and all the 13 millimeter nuts are going to be torqued to 20 Newton meters. Now we're at the point we're ready to reinstall our exhaust. All right, we've got everything loosely fitted. Now we can go ahead and install our exhaust hangers. It's definitely gonna be easier to do that before putting those clamps on. Slide these hangers on with ample room. Do the same on the other side. Make sure your hangers line up and go ahead and reinstall these triple squares that we removed, and then we're gonna torque these to 20 Newton meters. Now that these are fitted, we'll tighten up the exhaust clamps real quick. We're gonna torque them to 23 Newton meters. That pretty much takes care of the transmission mount and transmission mount insert. I hope you guys enjoyed today's DIY, and if so, hit that like button down below. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, be sure to drop that in the comment section below. And as always, please hit that subscribe button. We'll have plenty more DIYs on this vehicle and many others like it. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.